We all know that we're not going to get any more dollars to train geriatricians or to go to courses to learn how to care for older people. So I would tell oncologists, when they get older people and they're uncertain about them, to use available tools now that can help them do things like estimating survival. So an excellent tool, web-based, free to all professionals, is called ePrognosis. ePrognosis. And if you go on a site like that, you get a series of models that you can put in, not just the patient's hemoglobin or age, but you can put in whether they can walk unassisted, dress themselves, do certain activities of daily living that are key. And then they can give you an accurate estimate of the survival of the patient, because it's not the age, it's how long someone's going to do. Then when you know that, you at least have some frame of reference for what might be appropriate therapies. So something like that simple website, non-commercial, sponsored with a lot of federal grants, some easy stuff, coupled with things like learning how to do just a few brief tools in a geriatric assessment, including measuring cognitive function, little things like up and go tests, can give that oncologist a better idea of what are good options. And what's here now, although it's still being beta tested, are models that can actually predict chemotherapy toxicity. So you have Mary Jones in your office, and you're just not too sure how she's going to do with a type of chemotherapy treatment, and you can actually plug in, you can use a model developed by Arthi Haria or one by Martin Exterman that are available now, and get a better idea of how that patient may do with chemotherapy, far superior to things like the Karnofsky performance status, which a lot of doctors use. So I think it's, we got to get used to using the tools, we got to figure out how we can use them in a busy day that's getting busier. But I think we can do it.